Alright, hello everyone. Welcome back to The Odd Critic. This is episode 3 of the Modern Warfare 2 campaign walkthrough, whatever thingamajiggy I called it. Quick thing to point out, if you're looking for intel locations, or if you're looking for, like, cutscenes, if you want me to look, like, all the way through the cutscenes, like, before you start a mission, like, if I was to start this mission, saw the cutscene, if you want that, see the full of that, then you're not going to, because I just skipped those. Last time we left off, we completed the Hornet's Nest, which was, that was a fun mission. And Takedown, oh, that was even better. I hated those missions, it was like my least favorite. But, yeah. We're going to be playing Exodus and... we're playing... Oh, shoot. Never mind, we didn't play the Hornet's Nest last time. I thought we did, but we didn't. We're playing the Hornet's Nest and Exodus today. If I might think about it during the Let's Play. I might play The Only Easy Day Was Yesterday as well. I kind of want to get that mission out of the way. Because I don't want to start off the next episode playing... At most, I don't know how to describe this much. It's kind of boring. But yeah, let's play the Hornet's Nest on regular. And let's get into the game. The audio won't be up that much, so that way you can just hear the commentary a little bit better, because in the previous episodes, the audio was, like, crazy, sanic high. I'm not looking for that this episode and future episodes. I kind of want to keep the sound down just a little bit more. I do have subtitles on in case you want to... You know, still be engaged in the dialogue of the game. So, at least you guys have that. Yes. It's a nice cutscene, Skip. Right. You can see my frame rate counter in the top left. That's a Steam frame rate counter. That comes with Steam, and it's not as good as Fraps. But it's a lot more out of the way, and it allows me to keep track of my frame rate at all times, even when I forget to launch Fraps. Okay, just picking some people off. Fun fact, actually, first before I say anything else, I did actually record this episode a couple days ago, and this episode would have been out already by now. But, you see, something happened. I didn't cut the recording properly, I didn't end the recording. Because normally when I end the recording, I press a combination of keys on my keyboard, and that tells game DVR, hey, stop recording. Instead of doing that, I accidentally just quit out of the game. And I guess that just, like, exited the recording, and it didn't even save it anywhere. It just didn't do anything. So, that episode's history. But I'm recording it now, so I'm happy about that. I'll kill this guy. I've also been dying a load of times in my past episodes, and I may die right now. Shoot. Alright. Where'd he go? I've been dying a lot in my previous episodes. And I kind of don't want to die. At least not as much. In these episodes, so going to try not to. I haven't died yet. This episode, so that's already a start. Gosh, these guys do so much damage on regular. I hate the favela missions. Really don't like them. Dead. Wait, you can use these? Holy goodness, can I blow? Oh my goodness, I can. Oh shoot! Run! So yeah, remember how I said I didn't want to die as much? Oh my gosh, from here, are you kidding me? I might as well edit this bit out. I give up on life entirely. Okay, I'm gonna try to play this bit as fast as I can now. Without dying again, of course. Dang it, I gotta remember when I die. Then that restarts, like, this entire section. Oh gosh, I'm about to die again. Jeebus. Alright, well. Do you guys have any final words? Because I'm at a lack for words. At least for decent words right now. Because I just died too stupid. How did the truck kill me from that distance anyways? Seriously, it doesn't normally do that. Kill that guy. Kill this guy. Oh my goodness, that machine gun is like targeting me. I'm not saying much. I'm really just trying to play the mission and get back to where I was. I really hate these missions. I really do. They're just so evil. These are evil missions, and I hate them so much. Hey, you. You're dead. Dead. I'm not gonna do that again. I promise. Okay, let's game saved. That means if I die in the next few seconds, I'm gonna be alright. I really like the G18. Sorry, I'm not talking much, guys. I really am just trying to focus on the game because these missions I really hate, and I just really want to get through them. While minimizing the amount of time I have to play them. I gotta be at least a little bit careful, or else I'll just die again. Alright. I wonder how much ammunition does my G18 have? 193. Design flaw of this game is that if you have captions turned off, which I normally play with them off, and oh my gosh, I'm about to die. Normally, I play with captions off simply because what the characters tend to talk a lot. And that makes the captions pop up. And when the captions pop up, it blocks out your ammo in the lower right of the screen. As you can see, all my grenades and my stance and my ammunition and all that stuff. The captions block that out, which was a serious design flaw. I would normally play with captions on, like, all the time, if they didn't do that. Well, whenever I play this game and I'm not recording, then I just turn off the captions. Or turn on the captions. Just for you guys. Just because... I just, I don't know. I don't know. That's like the moral of me. I don't know. Okay, so killing some guys. Oh shoot. Seriously, did I actually hit him from this distance? No, I didn't. Just die, die. Get that. Oh shoot, stuff on my screen. I am right about to die. Though somehow, not quite sure how, I'm still alive. And I also just got that guy, and that guy. And oh shoot, ghost, no. Ghost, do me a favor and not die. Cause you're like the best. One best. Gosh, I hate these stupid RPG guys. Ah, that's grenade. Gosh, this mission is just so evil. Words cannot express how much I hate these missions. Just 'cause of how evil they are to you. And some of you may be going, oh, you're just a terrible player who doesn't know how to play. And well, okay, maybe I'm not an elitist. Maybe I'm not super hacks or, you know, blah, 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 blah at the game. I just hate these missions because, I don't know, I never quite get used to their brutality, as I like to refer to it as. Oh shoot, there's a guy right there. Alright, oh shoot, bumped the microphone there. You may have heard a slight bump on the microphone. Oh shoot, ow, went to scratch my nose, and does this get, oh no, he's not alive, then who's over here? Okay, apparently no one. Alright. Oh shoot, Soap, get up. You are like you should be the last person to die. In fact, fun fact, Soap was the last person that I saw die in the Modern Warfare series before I just like gave up entirely. It's like, if you're gonna kill off amazing characters, then you know what? Just get AIDS and just die, okay? Because Soap is awesome. He doesn't deserve to die. He's Soap. Also, amazingly, watch as Nikolai, like, runs away, and as soon as we clear this intersection, or this, like, marketplace, like, there's, like, barely anyone here, but, like, as soon as he leaves, there's, like, no one here, he could easily come back, pick us up, and go off, but no, we just cleared the place, and now we have to go this way, so, that's a stupid thing. Yeah, tell us something we don't know. Captain McTavish. So, I keep calling him Captain McTavish. I don't know. That's just me. Also, somehow I don't make this jump. Like, why would... Apparently, the only way to not make that jump is to dive at an angle. And why would I do that? Why would I do that? My character would never do that. My character's never done that. This is the only time my character, like, dives at an angle and doesn't make it. Seriously, this bit of gameplay, this bit of awful gameplay could have been completely avoided if the storyline writers had just been a little bit better at their job. Oh shoot, I wasn't running the entire time. Hey, run. Gas is very low. Nice. Whoa. Nice. Ew. Where to, my friend? All right, now. Finally got these awful, god-awful, so many levels of god-awful favela missions out of the way. You may be hearing, like, a rapper in the background right now. I have a box of Thin Mints with me, so I'm just, like, enjoying life. This is as celebratory as I'll get that these favela missions are finally out of the way. Alright. Sorry, I lifted the microphone up because I didn't think you guys would want to hear me chewing a Thin Mint. Alright. So, this is Exodus. It's like in Virginia somewhere, whatever, USA. Basically, all you need to know was that in the mission that I skipped, which was the shooting up an airport mission, you play, like, undercover as a guy who's supposed to be shooting up an airport, and you shoot up an airport, and then, like, you die in the end, and then the Russians discover that it's an American who, like, shot up a Russian airport. And then they're like, wow, Americans could do that to us, and here they are invading the United States. And basically, you're just here to stop them. And oh my gosh, look at that wiring! That like, someone just stuffed a shrub in here and expected that to work. Seriously, what kind of people are you? Electricians, like, look at that, that's just a- that's- Losing faith. Oh, okay, that didn't make me jump. Ooh, he went in his way! And died. my commentary at the moment probably is terrible by many standards, and I'm okay with that, because I don't know, that either makes me an absolutely terrible YouTuber or it makes me slightly different from the rest, or both. And also somehow I just died to some guy who I didn't even see. So yeah, things are going well. He's on the move. Okay, kill this guy. Kill these guys! How am I getting shot from this direction? Honestly, how? Oh, you took freaking forever to kill him, Sergeant Foley. You're a sergeant. Sergeants aren't that bad. Oh my gosh. Dude, I could take all of these people. I just took all those people. What are you doing? What? It didn't take that many people. The AI in this game did need work. I will say that much. Also, a vector. Yes, I am using a vector. Vector for the win. No, I'm going back and I'm refilling the ammunition on this thing. How did you guys do this sloppy of a job of clearing everyone out? Seriously, this sucks. We're being shot from behind because you guys just suck. Oh my gosh, and so does my aiming. Like, you guys, what were you doing there? Just sitting around, doing nothing. Alright, I am running in the middle of the road at the moment, during the middle of an enemy incursion, because that is logical. Okay. That should kill anyone in that general area, and it did. Oh, kill you. Okay. Go up here. Make sure everyone up here is dead. They are. Okay, cool. And go to the next pillar. I'm not using the striker support very much. So let's start using it. Let's paint that guy. And he's dead. Oh man, I like striker support. Ooh, paint these guys. Paint these guys. Oh shoot, I'm about to die, That may have sounded really weird. And basically what happened there was I saw a grenade, ran in that direction, saw a striker going this direction, and then I almost died by being run over by my own friendly support vehicle. And I tend to make stupid noises when I get frightened. So if you don't like that, then I'm sorry. You can feel free to leave anytime. Because frightened is something I tend to be when I'm playing games like this, or at least when I'm in situations like that. When you see like this giant thing running towards you and a grenade right there, and then you have to like run and there's a wall and then you can't run and then you die or almost die, then things get a little bit terrifying. All right, got the sentry. Oh, nice camouflage. I could hardly see you. I lifted up the microphone there so that way you wouldn't hear that cough. You know, I would edit these videos given, like, you know, they had a decent, like, because at the very least I would use Windows Movie Maker just to edit outfits, not to, like, add effects or anything, because I know Windows Movie Maker isn't really. Is pretty much terrible for that kind of purpose, but usually I would edit it out. And oh my goodness, the game is lagging. The power just went out, guys. The power just went out. Guys, the power is out. I'm now running on laptop battery. The power literally just went out. Gosh, I'm so glad I'm not playing an online game right now. Okay, so the power is out. And you'll probably notice because the screen brightness has dimmed. At least it has for me. Wow, okay, the power is out. Gosh, it's so silent because the AC isn't running. And I'm so used to that noise. Oh, it just cuts out. It gets... Okay, get that guy. Alright, get these guys. Also, if you haven't seen the previous episodes, which... Why would you watch the third episode first and then those episodes next? Doesn't make sense. I have a knack for, like, shooting out televisions in this game. And you're really gonna see that when we come up to these houses. Because these houses have, like, giant flat screens I love to shoot out. That's just a thing that I like to do, also. Oh, gosh. Yeah. I kind of regret eating that Thin Mint now, because that really got me. Oh! Oh! The power just went back on. You can probably hear, like, the microwave beeping out in the living room. Oh, gosh, okay. Alright, the power's back on. My computer isn't running terribly now. Dead. Wow, knifing. I need to do that more often. I just realized how easy it is. If you really do get it right, then it becomes just so easy. Like, knife. What? Oh, Jesus. Okay. Yay, I got killed by a phantom vehicle. Nice. Oh, but luckily I respawned here, so... Dead. No, don't hit me with an RPG, please. Kill that thing. Whoa, that was a weird glitch. Okay, yeah. I'm kind of getting destroyed here, so... you'll notice that the game may lag at oh, television. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know why I find that so satisfying. But, anyways, you may notice that the game just starts to lag a lot during certain parts. That may be when, there's, like, smoke particles on the screen or something. Because smoke just lags out the game entirely. Especially when I'm... See, I shot him, but he still killed me. Yeah, basically. Smoke just lags out my computer, especially when I'm recording, so that's not usually best of things. Okay, instead of doing that, I'm gonna throw a grenade, I'm gonna throw a flashbang, and I'm just gonna ignore that area for the next couple seconds. Kinda wanted to knife him. Oh my goodness, there's so many of them! And I just, like, killed all of them. I never thought I'd say that sentence and be happy with it, but... That's that, so. Yes. Alright, well, I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna try to kill everyone else. Go up here. Get everyone else up here. Next to a police car. I'm inside the house, you twat. Why are you calling my name? Okay, that's scary. Yeah. Hey, Striker, could you, like, kill them, please? No? Okay, fine. That's fine. Our survival is clearly less important than your survival. Got him. Shoot these guys. Alright, took out that one. And there is literally no more anti-air coming from here, but we still have to kill it. Oh, never mind, they still have this guy. Hi. Hey, I'm right here. What are you even shooting at? Shoot. Okay, I thought he would just ignore me, because I shot him and he ignored me, but apparently I get close, and then he's like, wait, what are you doing? I'm gonna shoot you now. That really actually kind of scared me. That gave me flashbacks from playing Conflict Desert Storm, when you're just, like, running close to a tank, and then suddenly it turns its turrets towards you, and then you die. Also, for anyone who actually feels like commenting, because I don't get many comments on my videos, for those of you who do actually play Conflict Desert Storm, feel free to leave a comment, because that game was awesome, and I may find a way to get a... Because I actually have the game on this computer, and it works properly, and it's amazing, and oh my gosh, I'm stuck in the pole. I just... Recording it with game DVR appears to just lag out the computer entirely, and that isn't really good. And... Like, the recording goes fine for the first, like, minute or two, but after that, like, when I get just slightly into the mission I'm playing, then the thing just, like, stalls out and just freezes up on me, and it's just terrible. Gosh, I really wish I knew my recording timer. Well, the HVI is dead. Oh no, the HVI. The game never tells you anything about the HVI. The HVI apparently is just this guy who, like, crashed and then went into a room and then died, and there's a briefcase, and you pick it up, and then there's nothing. The next mission that takes place with this unit that you're in, the next mission that takes place is in, like, Washington, D.C., and they do not mention the briefcase or anything a single time in those missions. So this briefcase, the HVI, whoever Raptor is from the last episode, that they're all just people that don't matter. So yeah, those are the thing. Save and quit. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that episode. I think I'm going to leave this mission for tomorrow. Yeah, it's probably most likely 30 minutes into recording now, and I wouldn't like it to go any further than that. So, yeah, if you liked the episode, feel free to leave a like, comment, rate, subscribe, whatever you want to do. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay awesome, everyone.